Baruch Hashem, we're starting Sefer Zemanim. The Rambam starts B'Shem Hashem Keleilom. He starts every Sefer, he starts with a pasuk. Nachalti Advisecho Le'elom Kisisein Libi Heima. The Rebbe spoke about this pasuk, like what's the connection between this pasuk and Sefer Zemanim? Nachalti Advisecho Le'elom Kisisein Libi Heima. And L'chur Adirab. In other words, Sefer Zemanim is talking about halachas, which are have specific times. Shabbos, Yontif, and Kippur, but Nechalti Ad Visecho Le'ilam sounds like something which is Le'ilam. It's Nechalti Ad Visecho Le'ilam. So why is it that this pasuk is the Hagdama for Sefer Zemanim? So the Rebbe says Adirab. Whereas normally you could think that there's certain mitzvahs which have specific times, and those mitzvahs are only connected to those times. Mashenken, when you're not, when in a different time, kill, you have no shakas to that mitzvah. So that's the chiddush. No, Nechalti Ad Visecho Le'ilam. They're all mitzvahs are Le'ilam. Even those mitzvahs that are connected to certain times, those mitzvahs are there lo'olam. You always have mitzvah Shabbos, and you always have mitzvah Yontif. Why? Because kisasein libehema. Since there's sasein libehema, so you're always living with all the mitzvahs, even though bepeil mamish, those mitzvahs are done in a certain time. It's also negeil legabe the din hachana to the mitzvahs that knows the shailas, when do you become mechuyev and those in yonim that have specific times. So there's a shaila about it. So I'll call upon him. This could also be again. Nachalti advisecho le'elam. In other words, teiru mitzvahs is lo'elam, even those mitzvahs which have specific times. Is nachamal. Nachalti advisecho le'elam, ki sesein li behema, sefer shlishi, v'hu sefer zmanim. Hilches of esav, v'zehu siduram, hilches Shabbos, hilches Erevin, hilches shvises oser. So the Rambam mentions Yom Kippur, the hamshach to Shabbos and Erevin, because Bepashtus, because it's more Kedusha than Yontif, and it's a Issacharis as opposed to Yontif, which is only Issalav. And then there's Hilchas Shvisas Yontif, and Hilchas Chametz Umatzah, Hilchas Shefer V'Sukkah V'Lulav, Hilchas Shkolim, Hilchas Kiddush Achedush, Hilchas Tainius, Hilchas Megillah V'Chanukah. Now then the Rambam, this is in the Rambam HaMeduyakim, the Rambam mentions all the halachas with all the mitzvahs in the halachas, before he starts Hilchas Shabbos. He goes through Hilchas Shabbos, Hilchas Erevin, all the mitzvahs in the halachas. Which means the Rambam, interesting, the Rambam mentions the mitzvahs three times. He starts, first of all, he starts in the beginning of the Sefer, right, Behemshach to the Hagdama. He mentions all the Yudalot Svarim, and all the mitzvahs which are in the Yudalot Svarim, all the halachas which are in the Yudalot Svarim. And then, not all the mitzvahs, all the halachas which are in the Yudal Svarim, and all the mitzvahs which are in each of the halachas. That he starts, number one. Then he, again, in the beginning of each sefer, again, he mentions all the halachas which are in that sefer, and all the mitzvahs which are in those halachas. And then, in the beginning of each halacha, he again mentions the halacha, and all the mitzvahs which are negeh to that halacha. Chapters three times. All right, we're not going to go through the halachas and the mitzvahs are that which are in this entire sefer right now. Hilchas Shabbos, yesh bechlolon chamish mitzvahs, shtei mitzvahs aseh v'sholish mitzvahs leisaseh v'zehu proton. Aleph, lishbeis b'shvi. So there's a chiyuv shvisa. Notice this: there's mitzvahs aseh which you have to do something, and over here the way you're mekayim this mitzvahs aseh is by being shavus, which is obviously passive. But it's a positive mitzvah. It's not only don't do malacha, it means be shavus. You should be shavus. Beis, shalilas is be malacha. Now, lepel, how are you shavus? By not doing malacha. If you do malacha, you're not shavus. But lepel, it's two inyanim. There's an inyan of being shavus, and there's an inyan of shalilas is be malacha. And the seid of the Rambam is always, the kamat always, I think, that the essence is before the leisasa. So in other words, there's a chi of shvisa, and then there's shalei lasses bei malacha. Notice lechura. This is a bit lechura that if the first you would say the lav. So basically, it's saying there's an isser to do malacha, and to be shavus kilu it's a chizuk to the isser of doing malacha. But that would be like kilu. The isser is a chizuk to the lav. Over here it's fakert. There's an inyan of being shavus. That's the inyan. There's a positive inyan of being b'shvisa. And then there's a din, yishalilas is b'malacha. Besides the fact that you're missing the positive union of shvisa, there's also an issur of lilas is b'malacha. Chura, that would be the havana of the difference if the lav would be before the essa or the essa comes before the lav. Kenza. Gimel, shleilanish b'shabbos. There's a din you shouldn't be manish b'shabbos. Dalit shleilotzis chutz legvul b'shabbos. And hey, lekadish hayem b'schira. Ubir mitzvaseilu b'prokum eilu perek rishon. Shvisa b'shabbos m'malocha mitzvah saseh. Shenamar ubayem hashvi tishbes. There's a mitzvah saseh of shvisa. V'chaleise m'malocha, v'aise bei m'malocha, is bitl mitzvah saseh. That's number one. And secondly, v'aver aleisase. Shenamar leisase kol m'malocha. Umau chayev alasiyas m'malocha. Is a masa b'ritzeni b'zodim chayev kores. V'imho yisham edin v'asro niskal. V'imasa b'shgoga chayev korb m'chatis chvo. What does it mean, chatos kvua? So there are certain chatois for certain things, mashal, if they said, tomi shenichnas lamigdosh, which is a carbon elevated. Carbon elevated means there's a person that's an usher, he brings a kivsa, and then a person that's a dal, he brings a, there's an eifas or a mincha, there's a carbon elevated, depends on how much money you have. Mashainkin over here, it's a carbon chatos kvua, it's a set amount, no matter, regardless of how rich or poor you are, there's a certain achatas which you always have to bring for a Shabbos. Kol makim shenama behilchus Shabbos she'isa dover zechayev. So what does chayev mean? It means I raise a chayev koras. If a person did it, he's chayev koras. V'imhoi yisham edim basro chayev skila. V'imhoi yisheg yigil chayev chatas. That's when it says chayev. Kol makim shenama she'isa dover zepotur. Is I raise a potur mina koras umina skila umina korb. Avol osur lasis eser dover b'shabbos. This is that's the Gemara says. Kol p'turi the Shabbos is poter avol osur. Poter means poter avol osur. And what's the issue when it says poter? V'isurim midivri seifim. Harchoka min amulacha. V'ha'ese eser b'zodin on something that you're poter is makan eser makas mardus. It was evan eser d'rabon. V'chein kol mokim shenamar ein oisin kach v'kach. So again, it says either it says potter, it says you're not allowed to do it, but it doesn't say that it's chayiv. It says then, when the halachas of Shabbos says you shouldn't do this and this, so if you did it, so you're makanes and makas mardas. Now, the pastors, why shouldn't you do it? Because it's the rabbanon. Even if it's an isa manateirech, it's chatzishir, you're also not allowed to do. But lepel mamish, there's no chi of minatera for it. Lepel, so it's makanes and makas markas. The chol mokim, I'm not sure about chotzishir, if it's actually makas markas, I don't know. The chol mokim shenemar mutal lasis kach v'kach, is a reza mutal chatchilo. The chen kol mokim shenemar in a chayiv klum, a potin miklum, if you did it. So again, is ein makanes and makas markas. So there's two lashen, there's lashen potter, or there's lashen ein eisen. There's a lashen mutter, and there's a lashon as in a chayiv klum. That's like the opposite of each other. Halacha hey. Good. So that's now the Rambam is going to tell you the rule of einu mischav. Dvarim hamutarim laseisun b'shabbos. Ubesas asiyosun efsher shetiyosun biglol malacha ve'efsher shaleitiyos. He's doing something which, from what he's doing, could come out of malacha. So the din is imle neschav and leisa malacha is areza mutter. Ketzad geir adam mita v'kisei umigdol ukiyetzben b'shabbos ubilvad shel yischav and lachper chiritz bekarka b'shas geir asim. He's schlepping a bench or whatever. He has no intention of making a chiritz. It's possible that it'll become a chiritz, but that's not his intent. Ulefichach im chofru hakarka ein echeshish bekach lefi shel neschav. Ein mischaven is beseder mutter. V'chein mahalach odem al gabi asabim b'shabbos u'bilvad shel yischaven lakereisam. Lefichach im nekru is ein cheshish. He's not worried about it, because even though he knew that it's possible that it should happen, and attacka happened, abu lepeil, since he had no intention for it to happen and it wasn't muchrach, we'll soon see that it should happen. So therefore, is ein cheshish. And vayta v'reichetz yodav be'afar aperes u'kiyetzabei. In other words, he's washing himself with something which could take off his hair from his hand, but on the other hand, that's not his intent. Now, there is a piritzat chukav, it's a small opening, mutar leikonis ba b'Shabbos aval pi shemeshir tzreiris. And l'chura the pshat is that maybe it's meshir tzreiris. It could be he's being meshir tzreiris, but that's not his intent. So the chen kol dover she'enem eschaven kegein zeh is a mutar. So enem eschaven is mutar. He's doing a maisa, and he knows that it's possible something should happen, but on the and it happened. Taka lepel, he didn't do anything wrong. However, osa maisa v'nasis biglola malacha shavadei tiyasa b'shvilei. So shavadei tiyasa b'shvilei esi maisa is aval pishalei neschaven lezachai, which we call a psikresh. Like I'll soon give the example. And if it's, he does something, which he's talking doing l'chura one thing, but on the other end, if something else is going to happen, which will definitely happen. He's schlepping a big bench. And that bench is a heavy bench. It's impossible to schlep such a bench on earth, on soft earth, without making a chritz. So it's not pshat, maybe it's going to make a chritz. It'll definitely make a chritz. So b'chia is gavner, then he's chayv. Sha'adavi yadua, she'yevshe she'tliyosa esim alocha. And Mamela, since it's a davi yadua, so therefore the heter of enim ischaven doesn't apply. Ketzad. Hareish tzorach l'reish oif l'sachik b'ilakotin. The chotach roishay b'shabbos is aval pi she'ein seif migamosei lahariga so'ev bulvad. The lashon Rambam is lahariga so'ev bulvad is chayiv. Sha'adavi yadua she'yevshe she'yachtech reish achay v'yichya el hamoviz bo b'shvile v'chein kol k'yetz b'shabbos. So he's tiny, he has nothing, he doesn't really, he has no interest in killing the bird. He wants to have the son, wants to play with the head of the bird. So he's going to take off his head. He doesn't mind if the bird remains alive. He has no intention of killing the bird, but he just needs the head of the bird. So on that we say, but by taking the head of the bird, it's inevitable that the bird will die. So the male is, so therefore the p'tur of Einim Eschaven doesn't apply there. I mean, you could say the pshat is because it's keil is love this. What's the havana of psikresha? The pashto, gur pashto is because it's keil you are mischaven. In other words, since you know you're doing it, and it's for sure this is going to happen, so in mele it's keil you are mischaven. But al kopon, that's this din. Saying the some people ask, what does it mean? Avo pisha ein seif megamose lahariga soev bulvat. L'chure ibechlal ein seif megamose lahariga soev. He's not interested in lahariga soev. And if he's interested in Hariga Saif as well, so then for sure that's not Einim Mischaven. When a person does something, he's pulling a bench and he wants both. So that's Lechura, not called Einim Mischaven. That's Lechura, not called Einim Mischaven. The Shaila, the Kapistmorim, asks this Kasha. What's this Loshna of Bilvat? About Kopan, so the Rambam is telling us the din of Einim Mischaven. Now Lechura, I'm just two horrors. First of all, l'chura the din of Einim Eschaven is not only a din of Shabbos. L'chura din of Einim Eschaven is in b'chol ha'teira kula. It's a whole shaila in b'chol ha'teira kula is in sugyas ha'gemara b'negeh Einim Eschaven machlekes Rabbi Yehuda and Rabbi Shimon, and Rabbi Shimon paskin that Einim Eschaven is mutter, and the Rambam paskin is that way that Einim Eschaven is mutter. I'm just saying, when you learn the Rambam over here, it sounds like it's a din in Hilchas Shabbos. L'chura the din of Einim Eschaven is a din b'chol ha'teira kula. That's number one, and secondly. Just another point, not a shaila, but when you get psik resha, the fiyadua, that the shaila is, what happens if there's a psik resha that's le nichole, or le ichpas le? In other words, I'm doing something which definitely will cause something else to happen, but the other thing that's going to happen doesn't really interest me. I have no interest in it. I have no interest in it. That's called the psik resha, the le nichole, or either I befeish don't want it to happen, or leich paslei, I don't care if it happens or not. So there's the shita sa'aruch that says that in such a case, even a psikresha is mutter. And there are other rishenim that hold no, that it's not mutter, but it's pater avalaser. And the Magad Mishnah brings here that it's pater avalaser. Taser is that it's pater avalaser. It's not mutter, but it's pater avalaser. Why should it be pater avalaser? So l'chura, the reason why it's potter, is because if it's lei nichalei and lei ichpaslei, so l'chura it goes into the gather of a malacha shein tzricha l'gufa, which we're soon going to learn about, that there's another gather called malacha shein tzricha l'gufa. There's two pturim. There's a ptur called einim eschaven, which is not, it's not really a Shabbos dikadin. Einim eschaven is a general din. I'm doing something, and something else is happening, and I have no intention of that to happen. That's the din of Einim Eschaven. And then there's the din of Psikresha. Now, what happens if this psik resh is lay nichali? So lechur, if it's lay nichali, so according to the aruch, there's no chsar psik resh if it's lay nichali, and therefore it's mutter. It's mamish mutter. Hashem and others learn that the MS it's sofkal sofarta psik resh, but on the other end, it's potter because it's a dover, because it's malach shen tzicha l'gufa, and a malach shen tzicha l'gufa is potter. That's how others learn. L'chura, the Rambam himself learns that Melachah Shein Tzricha L'Guf is Chayiv. So L'chura, according to the Rambam doesn't get involved at all. If this Einim is Chav and is Yeyich Pesle, Leyich Pesle, I'm saying Alderach HaPshat, I'm sure, Alderach HaPosh Pshat. So knows that Einim is Chav and is Mutter. If it's a Psik Reish, it's Osir. I is a psik resh lay nichale. It doesn't make a difference if it's lay nichale, because sof kol sof. What are you going to say? It's lay nichale, so it's a malach shein tzricha l'gufa. Good, but lepel the Rambam paskin malach shein tzricha l'gufa is also chayav. So mele, it's not a ptur of lay nichale. I'm saying that's l'chur al derech haposh b'shat. Halacha zayin kol le'esa malach b'shabbos. Is out here the Rambam talks about a malach shein tzricha l'gufa. So let's just make it clear. Einam is chavin means I'm not mitchavin for this to happen. I'm pulling a bench. I have no intention of making a chiritz. A malacha shein tzricha l'gufa means I intend on doing the malacha. I want to do what I'm doing. What I'm doing, I want to. But the reason why I want to do what I'm doing is not l'gufa. Now, the question is what l'gufa means. I don't need this to be. I need this not to be. We'll soon see. Kol eisa malacha b'shabas. Aval b'she'en etzorek l'gufa shal malacha. He doesn't need the gufa malach is chayiv ala ketzat. Hare shekiba es haner. Why? Mipnei shu tzorech l'shemen el psila kedei shal yabit. He doesn't want to lose the shemen or the psila. E kedei shal yisorif, e kedei shal yibok echere shal ner. It's chayiv. So what's the malach? The malach is kibui. And that's what he's doing. He intends on doing the kibui. But he doesn't need kibui for the gufa kibui. What would the gufa kibui be? So if he wants to make a psila, for example, he wants to make a pechom, that's by extinguishing the ner, so that it becomes a pechom, and that's a mile, he has a pechom. So if he wants the pechom, so he wants the gufa kibui, the pechom comes through the kibui. Over here, he doesn't want the pechom. He doesn't need, if there wouldn't have been a fire, everything would have been fine. He needs to get rid of this fire. What he's doing is there's no positive gain from it. The gain is only that there shouldn't be a chsar. That's the pashtus. He's mechabes haner in order that he shouldn't lose the shemen. If they wouldn't, he doesn't need the kibbutz. He needs that there shouldn't be fire. That's what he said. Nochamo. Ketzad. Arisha koves haner neshu tzorech l'shemen el psei l'kedei shel yavet ekedei shel yisorif ekedei shel yibok echere shel ner chay. Why? Nipnei she'akibu melocha bari neschava l'chabes. He doesn't need the kibui, but lepel he wants to do the kibui for what he does need. In other words, the pashtus, the way the Rambam was learning, means he's doing something, not that there's something positive from what he's doing that he has. What he's doing is only to get rid of a problem. He's getting rid of a problem. The case of the Gemara, the Mishnah would be, he's being moitzi sames. It's not he has a samayla with the mess being outside. He doesn't want the mess here, so he's moitzi sames. So that's malachah shein tzricha l'gufa. There's other pshatim in Lachash in Tzricha L'Gufa, the way Taisus learns, and the Kesem Mishnah brings here that Lachash in Tzricha L'Gufa means the Gufa Melacha means the way it was done in the Mishkan. And anything that's not done for what it was done in the Mishkan is not called Gufa Melacha. I'm saying it could be, but that L'Chura in Lashon HaRambam, what we're saying is what in Lashon HaRambam is I don't want the positive aspect of what I did. There's only taking away something, a problem. Okay. So we learned about Einam Eschavim is Mutter, and Dover of Mlachish and Tzichol Guf is Chai, which is like a Yisod, it's a big Machlekes or Rishenim, Altrever brings two days, what's the Halacha, but the Rambam Paskins, Mlachish and Tzichol Guf is Chai, and Einam Eschavim is Mutter. Kol ha-mischaven, lasis molocha. V'nasis le-molocha achere, shenin l'schavala. So he wanted to do one molocha, and l'peli did another molocha. It's also potter ala. It's not mutter, it's potter. L'fi sheli nasis machshavti, Kate said. Zorak even ichetz b'chaveire ibe behema, k'dei l'horgon. V'holach v'okar ilam balichose, v'lei horak. They're both a yisr. To kill is a yisr, and to be oikar on ilan is an yisr. He wanted to kill, and he was oikar on ilan. Is that is a potter? In kal v'chemer, in the schavel yisr kal, v'nasi yisr chomer. In this case, was both of them are yisr deraisa. Kigen shen schavel is the karmelis. And v'avra, evan v'rishus haram, is also certainly shul potter. V'chein kol ki etzibaza. The schavel lasi is dover amuter. Also dover acher, kigen shen schavel lachter chazatolush. He wanted to cut tolush, and Lepeli ended up cutting something that's mechuber, so he had no kavanah for malacha itself. So there could be a mitzvah. He wanted one malacha and he did it another malacha. So he's potter. He wanted a rabbanon and he did a deraisa. He's also potter, certainly potter. But over here he didn't want to do anything and he ended up doing a deraisa. So he's in. So he didn't do anything. Zayin chayiv klum. Halacha tes. Nischaven lelaket ta'enim shcheres, v'liket levonis, eish nischaven lelaket ta'enim v'acharkach hanovim, v'nepach hadover, v'liket hanovim betchilo, v'acharkach ta'enim potem. V'af al pi shaliket kol ma shechoshav, heil v'liket keseda shechoshav potem, shebelei kavona osa, shelei osra teira elu meleches machshavos. So this is a new din in Hilchis Shabbos that you need a meleches machshavos. So therefore, even though he wants taking Te'enim and Anovim are both Aser, there's an Iser, whether he's taking Te'enim or he's taking Anovim, and they're both the same Iser, is the Iser of Toilish, of Koitzer. But on the other hand, since he's interested in doing this type of an Iser, and he ended up doing the same Iser in a different form, so that, Mitzad Didin of Meleches Machsheves, it's a special Pturim Shabbos, special Pturim Shabbos. Now this din, the story, he wanted to be malakat te'enim v'acharkach hanovim. And Lepeli was malakat hanovim v'acharkach te'enim. So l'chura, I mean, the pastus, what does it mean he was malakat te'enim? What happened? Nepach hadovim, he was malakat hanovim and then te'enim. So if the story was, he wanted to be malakat te'enim and then he wanted hanovim, Lepeli ended up being malakat hanovim, which he really wanted to do te'enim. Now all of a sudden he chapsach that he wanted to do anovim, that he wanted to first do te'enim. Lepeli did anovim. So now he wants to do te'enim. So lechura ein achinami. His first svara rishena was to do first this and then this. But Lepeli, since by accident he did the mistake and in his malakad already the second what he wanted to do. So ein achinami. For what he did, he's potter because that's not what he wanted to do. But now lechura what he wants to do is the second. So lechura washing nibichayim. I mean, what's the seder? What's the seichel? So l'chura, you're going to have to say pshat. L'chura, maybe that's posh pshat. That the pshat is that while he was doing both, he thought he was doing the other. Because he was being malakat two things, and maybe he wasn't paying attention. His mind was he's going to be malakat anovim and then te'enim. And l'peil, somehow or another, he got confused, and he ended up being malakat te'enim. So when he thought he was being malakat anovim, he was being malakat te'enim. And when he thought he was being malakit, whatever, the other one, see, he was malakit the other one. So he knows, it's not pshat. He came to the realization he made a mistake. And now he decided that he's going to do the other one because that's the only one that's left. But that wasn't his original intention. So therefore he's potter. I mean, why should he be potter? Because it wasn't his original intention if this is his intention now. So l'chud is posh, that's a pshat. Alderach said the next case, halacha yud, hoyu lefon of shtei neiris delkis, ekvuyes, and ischaven, next halacha yudal, hoyu lefon of shtei neiris delkis ekvuyes, and ischaven lechab ezer vekov ezer, elhad legzu vehidlik ezer ischai, that's yachai. Sharei, osa minam malacha shechoshev lasei, so that's what he wanted to do, he wanted to either kindle an air or extinguish an air. Halamazad deima, he wanted to take a teina, he took a teina. So also a chiddush. that a person wants to kill. Lepel, he wanted to kill the Reuven, and he ended up killing Shimon. So Lepel, since he wanted to kill, then he did kill. So even though, so if a person wanted to take a Te'ena, and by accident he took an Anovim, so that's not the Malach he wanted to do, because he wants Agam Lechura, they're both a Maisa Lekita. So it's hard to understand. In other words, he wanted to do a Maisa of Keitzer, of a Te'ena, that he wants a Te'ena. The pale, he ended up getting a grape. So he said, you wanted a Te'ena, you didn't want a grape. So in Mele, so it wasn't, that's felt Malach's Machshavas. Mashainkin, if you wanted to kill Reuven, you killed Shimon. So you wanted to kill. Well, might have come in, Reuven and Shimon. It's a little bit tzarech beer to understand why, if I wanted to take a grape and I took a te'ena, a fig, it's a problem. I didn't do what I wanted. Mashainkin, if I wanted to kill him, but since you wanted to kill someone and you killed someone, mitzad the melacha, there's no difference. He said, mitzad the maisa melacha, it's no difference. But over there, it's also mitzad the maisa melacha of Ketzer, is also no difference. Okay. So over here, you also have to say pshat. He wants the first, he has two candles. One was lit and one wasn't lit. And what he wants to do is first light the one that wasn't lit and then extinguish the one that was lit. That's what he wants to do. In the pale, he did fakert. First, he extinguished the one that was lit, and then he lit the one that wasn't lit. So, Bechura, so we say like this, when he extinguished the one that was lit, he didn't want to do that. That's not what he wanted to do. What he wanted to do right now was to first light the candle that wasn't lit. So, mainly, he did something which he didn't really want to do. But La'achar HaMais, La'achar, he already extinguished the one that was lit. So, now he has two candles that weren't lit. And now he's going ahead, and he's lighting a candle that wasn't lit. So that's what he wants to do. So why shouldn't he be chayav? So that wasn't his original plan. So this is his second plan. So you're not chayav when a person had an original plan. Now he has a different plan. So you're not going to be chayav. It's not shaychus azamitzias. So you have to say pshat is that somehow or another he's like he's not coordinated. In other words, he's doing two acts. He's lighting a candle and he's extinguishing a candle. And his mind, he wants to maybe do one act first, and then the other act second. And Lepeil, he ended up doing the act that he wanted to do first, he did second, and the act that he wanted to do second, he did first. And while he was doing both, it's not what he really wanted to do. So both acts is not really what he wanted to do. And Memela, so he's Potter. You notice he's doing an act which he thinks somehow or another, he's losing coordination of what he's doing. He's doing two acts, one after the other. And in his mind, he's doing first the lighting and then the extinguishing. And Lepel, he ended up extinguishing and then lighting. So while he was lighting, he's like, he thought that he's doing extinguishing. That's Lechura Pshat. I mean, I don't see any other Pshat. And then that's the beginning of Allah Hirav. Then he says, Kova Zubi Hidluk Zubi Neshimachas. He was intending on first kindling one and then extinguishing the other. And Lepel, he ended up lighting and extinguishing at the same time. So over here is chayv. So even though he really intended on doing one first and then the other one second, but if he did them together, he's chayv. So over here they bring from the Rogatchover that the Rogatchover says he's only chayv for the extinguishing. And he's not chayv for the kindling. And the Havanas Advarim is when a person wants to kindle first and then extinguish. So really his intent is to kindle first. That's his intent. He doesn't want to extinguish before he kindles. That's how we're somehow or another interpreting as a kavana. He wants to kindle first, and he doesn't want to extinguish before he kindles. But he doesn't mind extinguishing while he's kindling. There was no stira to his kavana, the fact that he's extinguishing while he's kindling the other. But on the other end, he didn't want to kindle. He wanted to kindle first. So Lepel, since he didn't kindle first, because he kindled together with the extinguishing, so the kavana of the kindling, to kindle first, he didn't have. But on the other end, the kavana of extinguishing, he did have. He wanted to extinguish after he kindled. It's not he wanted to extinguish after he kindled. He didn't want to extinguish before he kindled. But as long as he extinguished together with the kindling, that goes into the original kavana of the kindling and is chayav for the kindling, for the extinguishing, I'm sorry, and that is chayav for the extinguishing. That's what the Rogatchover says pshat. I mean, when you read the Rambam Poshet, the Rambam says chayav, the Pashas Sudvarim is chayav for both. To say the Pashat of Pshat, what they bring from Rabbi Gershom also, that's how he learns Pshat in Christmas. Sha'aval pisha lehigdim hadlaka, aber hayli hichara yisrael, l'shteim ka'achas, l'ficha chayiv. Since it was shteim ka'achas, so therefore he's chayiv, and according to Rabbi Chava, he's chayiv for the kibbutz. V'chein kol kiyetze b'zeh. V'chol le'esem alocha, that's the number, now there's l'chura a third alocha. When a person does a malacha kimis asik, that was not specific. Kimis asik, v'lein eschava lapotu. Now the ma'ase is the Rambam originally in halacha ches said that neschaven lasi is davar amuter v'asu davar acher. Neschaven lachtech zatolish v'chotech samachuber is eini chayiv klum. So Lechuri, he said, Eini Chayiv Klum. So Lechuri, it's more than Potter. Potter, he said, is Potter Avalosser. Over there, he said, Eini Chayiv Klum. And here, the Rambam is saying, Cholaisim Malacha Kim is Asik. V'lein is Chavon Lo, he's Potter, but he didn't say Eini Chayiv Klum. So there's like talk about it a little bit. I mean, there's, Bechlal, in Misasik, there's two in Yonim. There could be a Metzias where a person in his Chavon Lachtech Tolush Zeh, and v'chotach mechuber acher. That's one level of misasik. And then there's another level where he wants to be lachtik this item, but he thought that this item was a tolish, and lepeil it was a mechuber. So it's brought down that when a person was this chava lachtik tolish zev, v'chotach mechuber zev, so what he did, he b'chlal had no kavana. So then he's taka enel chayiv klum, then he's potter legamri. Masha'enkin, it was this chava lachtik zev, and v'chotach zev, but lepeil, he thought it was a tolish. And Lepel ended up being a mechuber. So then he's taka potter. He's potter, but he's not a shaygig, he's a potter. But on the other end, he's not any chayiv klum. Over there, he's potter, but he did a maise issa. Sof kol sof, he was choytech something on Shabbos, and he was nischava lachtech on Shabbos. He just didn't realize that what he's doing was a maise malacha. So he wanted to do what he's doing. He didn't realize it's a issa. He didn't realize what he's doing is mechuber. So therefore, he's potter als misasik, but it's only a potter. Mashenkin, when he did an act which he bechlal didn't want to do, he was nisav chavon lastik tolish zeh, and he ended up being choytech hamechuber. So over there, it's eini chayiv klum. It's negeh bechlal also negeh babus teshayla negeh misasik b'shabbos, which is a close the keshayla. When a person does a maisa b'shabbos and an eifin of misasik, is the pshat is that he did an aveira, and lepeil he's not chayiv. Other pshat is that there was no avera klal. Marshal, someone sees someone doing an avera, that's misasik. He has no idea. You know, there's something in someone's pocket. Person, as far as he's concerned, there's nothing in his pocket. He checked his pocket, there's nothing in his pocket. Someone went ahead after he checked his pockets and put something into his pocket. And he walks out in the street and he does it and he carries. So is the pshat, so he was carried bay from misasik. He wasn't a shegik, it was a misasik mamish. Now the question is did he do a maisa malacha? Or he didn't do a ma'isim halacha. So let's talk in Achrein with the Kveger about it. Halacha Yud Beis. Kol ha-mischaven lases malacha v'nases b'yeser al kavanosei is chayiv. B'pachas mikavanosei potter. Keset. Hareishin is... So over here we're doing a malacha, and lepeil, what he did, he ended up doing even more than he meant to do. So that is chayiv. B'pachas mikavanosei potter. What does that mean? Keset. Hareishin is chavin lohoitzi masa la'achrof. And when you carry something, when you carry it behind you, it's not so watched. When you carry it in front of you, so that's it's more of a shmir. So you intended on carrying it something behind you. Ubalu lefonav, it ended up being, unintentionally, it ended up coming be lefonav. It's chayiv. Sharin is chavin l'shmir ha'pchusa. You are mischavin to do something which is a shmir ha'pchusa, and that's a shmir ha'mula. Aval mischava lehitzi lefon of a bolle lachr of his potter, shari mischava lehitzi bishmira mu'ula, vehitzi bishmira pchusa b'chen kol kietz b'zah. Zagam, he was nischavim for hitzo, but he was nischavim for hitzo b'efen kozer that there'll be a shmira mu'ula. And lepeil, he ended up having a hitzo, which was a shmira pchusa. So again, that's a chsarim, that's a din shabbos, because melech is makshavis osr teira. And since his machshava was a shmira mu'ula, it would be stamazach, it would be a din melech machshavas, it wouldn't be a ptur. But since over here melech is machshavas asr teira, so therefore he wanted to have a shmira mu'ula, and Lepeli ended up having a shmira p'chusa, mele felt in machshav. Hoye chogur besinner, v'hishlech hamaser bin psori v'chalukir. Sinner is some type of a girdle which could turn around, and it's like it's tight on the person. So you could put something in between the sinner and the person to hold something. It's between this piece of clothes and his flesh. When you put something in a position where you could expect things to change, so therefore you can't say that my intention was it should be in such a position. You a person understands that it could change, so therefore that's all part of his intent. So over here we're seeing a tenth is very, very important. So if a person wanted to do a big malacha, and Lepeli ended up doing only half of it, so what he did taka was a shir. But Lepeli, it's not really what he wanted to do. So Lechura, maybe there's a p'tur. So that the chiddush is, no, it's not a p'tur. So no, even though nischav and shmira mu'ula, and he had a shmira p'chusa, is potter, because Lepeli, what he did was with the shmira p'chusa. It's not like half. he did what not what he wanted to do. Mashayim over here, what he did was what he wanted to do. He wanted to do more. So then he's kaif. Kesef. Harishin is chavon likri lichte vigeres ishtar b'shabbos. Ein neimrim leizchayiv zeh sheyashlim chefse v'yichtiv kol ashtar ekol higeres. Elu mishayichtiv shtei esis ischayiv. V'chein mischavon lerig belged shalim. Mishayereg shnei chutim is ischayiv. Avol pishe kavonosi lahashlim. O behel v'osu kishir b'kavon echayiv. V'chein kol kietzbos. Kol malacha shayochid yochalasis esu levadi v'osu esu shnayim b'shutfes bein shosu zem miktsos v'zem mitzos shen sh'okar zeh achefetz m'shus zu v'inichi hasheni b'shus acheres, the first mishnah in Shabbos, of zeh eke v'zem miniach o bein shosu esu shnayim keachot mitchil v'achsev ki gen sh'ovzu shnayim b'kulmes v'kosmu Eyogzu kiker veitziyu mershus l'rishus is harei l'ptur. So there's a new ptur of shnayim shasu, which is also, it's a ptur in Shabbos. It's a ptur in Shabbos. It's not a ptur b'chol ha'teir kula. It's a ptur b'Shabbos. There's a b'kiveger in Kalayim that brings out that b'negeh, that there could be a mitzvah of shnayim shasu over there, and it's zeh yochel v'zeh yochel, and they're both chayiv. The ptur of shnayim shasu is a ptur in Shabbos. So special limud, v'im ein echad mem yochel aseisa levadei at sheitztarfu, gin shnayim sh'och zukeira v'itziyu l'rishus haram, is heil v'ein keil b'echad mem laseisa levadei, v'osu eise b'shutfes, mitchila v'atseif, v'shneim chayov, and u'shir echad l'shneim. So, marshal, there's a shir, how much you have to be moitzi, if the two people are being moitzi together, one shear, so from that's when you're chayv. You only need a shear for each one. Each one is considered doing the malach. Hoye koyach be'echad lohitzi kere zu levadi. Vasheni eini yochel lehitzi levadi. V'nishtat v'shneim v'itziyo. So then the rule is that rishon sheyochel is chayv. Vasheni is considered a misayehu. He's not part of really doing the malach. He's only a misayeh. So that's the general rule, and that's a rule that when one person is able to do something and the other person is not able to do it himself, so he goes into the other misayeh ain't b'mash. When two people are doing in shneim yochol, so that's a special din in Shabbos. Shneim shasu is p'tur. Mashenkin of Zay Yochel, is any Yochel, that's a general din of Messiah in Bemash. Halacha Yud Zayin. Kola Mekalkal in Pturim. So there's another din that the Maisa Shabbos has to be a Maisa. First, we'll learn that we'll din of Mlechis Machshavis. A Maisa of Shabbos has to be a Melech of Tikkun, not Kilkul. Ketzad. So later on, we're going to learn if you chovel b'chaveri, and through that your anger gets a little bit baruyikt. So that's not considered derech hashchosa. In other words, you accomplish something. But over here, it was derech hashchosa. It wasn't a psa. Derech hashchosa dikeifan. Shchovel b'chaveri b'beim derech hashchosa. V'chein im korab godim a sorfon a shavar kelim derech hashchosa. He did these acts, and it was a derech hashchosa. Korab godim is pashas myself. There's an issa called korea, and sreifa is also issa sreifa. Shavar kelim. There's an isser of, you have to know what's the isser of Melechus Shabbos, which he could be chayiv, and he's only potter because he's mekalkel. And we have to talk about a Melechus Shabbos. And there's a choyvel is a Melechus Shabbos. Kireya, Sreifa, Shavar Kalim, Derech Hashchosa is also Hariz a potter because it's a mekalkel. Kofar Guma, Ve'eni Tzorech Elo Lafra. Person digs a hole, he's not interested in the hole, he just needs the earth. Now, what's the malacha? The malacha is the chafira. What's the malacha of the chafira? So, the mufarshim will be explained. Magen Mishnah, there's two dinim of chayfer. There's a chayfer babayis and there's a chayfer basod. A chayfer basod is chayrish, and a chayfer babayis is boina. So, when a person is chayfer babayis and ain't it tzarech el lafra, he doesn't need the guma. So he's a boiner, but he's a mekalkel. He's not interested in the. It's considered vice to a mice binyan because the pail he made a hole. But on the other hand, he's a mekalkel. He's a mekalkel potter. On the other hand, if he makes a hole in the soda, so they bring that the hole in the soda is not really a mekalkel. It's not called a mekalkel in the soda or hole, and therefore it's a mice chrisha nervos. He's not really interested in it. So it's referred to, the Gemara calls it a malacha shen tzricha legufa. A chayfer guma vein etzorech el afra goes into the gather malacha shen tzricha legufa. And according to the Rambam, malacha shen tzricha legufa is chayef. So memela a chayfer guma besoda wutaka be chayef. That's what the Magen Mishnah brings over here. But, but lepeil, the Rambam doesn't say, I'm just saying, in derech hapshat, gor pshat, the Ram doesn't say. The Ram just says chafar guma ve'in etzorech el afra is areza mekalkul upati. He doesn't say that it's talking about bebayis. The Mefarshim say that it means bebayis based on the Gemara. Areza mekalkul upati. Afal pi she'asim melacha hail the kavanose lekalkul. And here also the Ram says hail the kavanose lekalkul, which also is tzorech bir. L'chura, is it a maisa kilkul or kavanose lekalkul? So notice. So soon we're going to learn that if there's a mekalkel amenas l'sakin, then he is chayv. There's potter on kil, and then he's chayv on kilkel. Maybe that's what he means. I'll call upon nochamol. He's saying a rule that a mekalkel is potter. And the examples of a mekalkel is potter is choval and korab godim, shavakelim and chofer guma vein etzorech elu lafra. And over here he says, "Avol pish asim alocha hail the kavanosi lekalkel potel." What does it mean? The kavanosi lekalkel. Alocha yudches. Now kol amekalkel amenas lesaken is chayv. So if the kavanosis is not lekalkel, but it's amenas lesaken is chayv. Case. Harei shesosar kidei livneis bimkemi. So over here the Rambam says kidei livneis bimkemi. A shemochak kidei lichtev bimokim shemochak. A shechafar guma kedei livneis b'techo yisaidus v'chol kiyetsa b'zeh is chayif and v'shiyuron kimasak. So he gives an example that the kabbia mitzvah that it's a mekalkel. Right now you're being mekalkel, but lepeil this kilkel is al menas l'sakim. So what is the case? Sosar al menas livneis b'mkemi. So what? There's a malacha called soiser. Now if the soiser is a kilkel dika soiser you're potter. But if the soiser is in order through the seiser to be a binyan, so then you're chayev. How much are you chayev? A bein is kolshu, so seiser is kolshu. Al dar is a mochak kidei lichtev. So there's a maisa malacha called mochak. And if you're moichik kidei lichtev b'mochim shemochak, so that's called a soiser amanas livnis, a mekalkel amanas l'sakir. Now, l'chura, by mochak kidei lichtev, that's the gufa malacha. The Rambam is saying it. like that there's a mitzvah called moichik is a mekalkel, and if it's a manas lichtev, so then this is a mekalkel, a manas lesaken, and then you chayiv kishir hamesaken. In the Mishnah, when the Mishnah says moichik, the Gemara says moichik a manas lichtev. That's the gather of moichik. That's the guv hamelocha of moichik. Moichik a manas lichtev. The Rambam is saying it. Moichik is a mekalkel, and if it's a moichik a manas lichtev, it's a mekalkel a manas lesaken. And therefore, the shear is kedei lichtev, which is the shear kishir amasak, and that's why you have to be meichik enough to be able to rash the aces. That's how the Rambam says. So the Rambam says the Mishnah Brura in Bir Alach in Shin Mem Taka brings this Rambam, and he's in Tainis over there. He says there's a Mishnah says meichik amanas lichtev. What happens if a person is meichik and the gufa mechik is a tikkun? Because you have a beautiful picture. And some ink fell on the picture. So you want to get the ink off. So you're not taking off the ink in order to write on the ink there. Fakir, you're taking it off because the ink is a chsar. It's a chsar in the whole matzav. So this moichik is matzimatik, and it's not a manas lichtev. So he's tiny, that's for sure chayiv. You know, a meichik, a manas lichtev, the pshar is ba'atzim, I'm being moichik something. And it's al manas lichtev. What? I'm being mekalkel al manas lichtev in order to make a tikkun. Masha'inkein. If the mechik in itself is a kilkul, is a tikkun. So then you taka don't have al manas lichtev, and then there wouldn't be a din of kishir shteis. That's what he writes over there. The churban al-Tirebbe seems to be saying that a mechik, if it's not al manas lichtev, it's bechlal not the guf amechika. Because the God says that. That's all the al-Tirebbe brings in also in Shema. That a mechik shalei amanas lichtev is bechlal not the tzuras hamalacha the way it was in the Mishkan, and the mail is not chayiv. So lechura you need over here that the Rambam is lechura saying again that a mechik is a mekalkel, and the reason why amanas lichtev is chayiv is because it's a mekalkel amanas lesakin, and the shir is kishir atikun. It's tzarech, lechura tzarech beer a little bit why. And Lepil, if you're mechik l'mashal things that's not a kilkul, you're mechik things that are just a blotch of ink. So how are you being mekalkel? You're taking over this blotch of ink that's called a kilkul. How is that a kilkul? You're saying it's a mekalkel and it's a manas lichtev. Okay, anyways. L'chura, the manas lichtev tutuf, that the mechik has a meaning. Whereas the gather of mechik is that you're making place for something to write. If you're not intending to write, so you're not making place for something to write. Okay. Anyways, the Rambam says that moichik amanas lichtev is a tzir of a mekalka amanas l'sak. And v'shiurim nochamol kidei livnis b'techi yisaydes v'chol kietz b'zachay v'shiurim kishir amasak. Kol eis aloch yutas. Kol eis amalocha b'shabas. Miktsose b'shgog o miktsose b'zodn. Bein shehezid l'b'seif shogag. Bein sheshogag l'b'seif hezid potter. Achiyase shir malacha kula mitchilu vatzev bezodn v'chakach yechayev kores v'miya beidem v'asro chayev skilo oi shiyase shir malacha kula b'shgoga mitchilu vatzev v'chakach yechatev achiyase shir malacha kula b'shgoga mitchilu vatzev v'chakach yechayev chatev skvo. So if you do, let's say, one ois b'meizid and the other ois b'shegig or fakert, so you put the seifem achatev and seifem kores. It's pashtus.